Good morning. Welcome to my life, my DIY life on Mount Tammany Ridge. We have a small piece of land up here in northern New Jersey, and you know, you're going to be seeing some things on here like using some farm equipment, you know, light construction equipment, skid steer, mini excavator, maybe a little bit of hot shot hauling, some for small farms and some for, you know, what I do for a living on an everyday schedule. We have some horses. You'll be seeing some things with that and maintaining fence and just other DIY things that pop up on a, you know, a DIY person's honey-do list on almost a minute basis. Things change from minute to minute, even maybe down to the second. So, you'll be seeing some snow management. We got the winter season coming up, so that should be pretty good. And, you know, some welding, fabricating, you know, and when I say fabricating, I mean farm fresh fabricating. We're not talking about I'm a legitimate welder. These are just things that I do around the farm here to get by, you know. So, welcome to DIY life on Mount Tammany Ridge. We're going to have a very small, almost insignificant project going on today. Got to take out a couple fence posts that have been, you know, needed to be relocated slightly. We changed some of the fence placing, so it's going to require us to do a couple modifications to accommodate a gate. So that's really all we have going on today. We got to take out some old ones, move them, put some new planks in. It's desperately need for new planks. The horses have kind of ravished the planks pretty good. So, and so is over 20 years of time. So, we'll see you shortly. Let me go get some things ready. And we'll take you along for our little project. I hope you enjoy what you see, and please like, comment, and subscribe if you feel that you want to. And we'll see where all this goes. All right, so here we are. We're back out here in the yard trying to get prepared for getting this excavator fired up. We got a couple posts to pull out of the ground, and we'll have to see. I don't know. Call me lazy, but I really don't feel like pulling out the spud bar and yanking around on a post to get it to pull out of the ground. So we're going to use the excavator and got to get down to the barn and get the old post hole digger set up on the tractor. And if my memory serves me correct, we might have to do something to the post hole digger before we can actually use it. I hope that's not the case. Hopefully it's as easy as finding the right size nut to put on the shear pin, and that's that, I hope. We'll see. I'll be back with you in a minute. All right, so we're down here by the implements, and this is our recent purchase, this auger here. It's as you can see, I don't know if you can see it in the camera, but it's already it's already been christened. The shield up top right here is bent because a shear pin walked its way out, and when it stuck out, it snagged it and kind of opened up that shield a little bit. So that's another project I'm going to have to do to straighten that back out so that these two legs here will stand, I don't want to say square because it's a triangulation kind of thing, but you know, they'll be straight to where they're supposed to be anyhow. So I'm going to go grab the tractor. I'm going to bring it on over here, and we're going to get this thing hooked up, and I'll try to keep my vocabulary family oriented. That's the whole goal here. But any of you guys that already do this type of stuff and wrestle these things, these 3-point implements, it's kind of like the first time every time. In some cases, this one has proven to be nowhere near as bad as the old one from like the 1950s. So we're gonna see what goes on here. So I'm gonna go grab that thing. I'm gonna bring it over here. You can see Bo here in the background. He's absolutely gaga over anything that you could throw, anything, stick, ball, frisbee, And you might find him being a little bit vocal in the background and how can I say, yeah, demanding that we throw the Frisbee or whatever it is he decides to see. You know, he wants to see if he gets frequent flyer miles and chases. So anyway, I'm going to go get the tractor. I'll be back here. We're going to get this thing put on. Throughout this whole process here, you can see there's a rollover protection bar that we have folded down. And me being 6 foot, I usually can't help but smack my head into it. So when you see me do this, and you're probably going to be able to fill in the blank. But I said, I'm going to try to keep it quiet. Thanks. Doesn't usually work like that for me. Usually, yeah, I don't know. In front of the cat, why? Well, that was way more painless than I thought it was going to be. So we're going to get on over to the barn there. And my father, Greg, has been over there the whole time I've been monkeying with this thing. Kind of getting the old planks cut off and, you know, getting prepared for me to pull them posts out. And just kind of trying to multitask. We got this rain coming in and we really don't want to get stuck out here. And it's still... You can see my breath, so rain and seeing your breath, no bueno. So, yeah, I'm gonna cut this off right here, and we'll see you back over there. All right, so we're back on. We're over here working on tearing these posts out. We got a couple planks left. Heck, I thought we had three. I guess we only got two. Whoop. And we've got a dog that's absolutely persistent about this silly Frisbee. That's gonna be fun. All right, so I'm gonna get this gate. You can see it's sticking past the post here, and we're trying to move this post to accommodate the size of the gate.
A hammer.
We got a hammer?
Yep. There should be one on the back of the Ranger.
Yeah, I did. All right, well, that was pretty painless. I'm gonna swing over there real quick, grab the excavator. No pun intended there. We're gonna get these posts popped out, hopefully in short order. This 6x6, or is that an 8x? That's a 6x6, I believe. Could be a little bit of a fight. We'll see what happens.
Out of the way, well.
there is where we want the new hole.
Okay.
Look out for landmines here.
All right.
Looks like Ellie left us a present.
Great.
Oh, it's okay. We're surrounded by it around here. It's a bunch of horses anyway, right? So I'm going to grab the tractor. I'm going to back on in here and see if we can punch a couple holes in the ground and get ourselves well on our way to staying dry. It's not god awful. I thought we were gonna run into a rock for sure, because we're all kind of downhill. But we got a lot of topsoil down this part of the property, because naturally we're at the lowest. Well,
almost the lowest point of the property. So naturally we're going to have more topsoil down here than obviously the top of the hill. So my father went to go grab the manual postal digger so I can clean this hole out a little bit better, and then we'll probably just move on to the next. I don't want to put an obstruction there and have to work around it. hole, you mean after we put the post in, you want to put like a shoulder, like a shelf down?
Yeah.
Okay. Much for needing a skid steer.
Okay.
Well, want me to get a little tap or? Well, I mean, I can cut out this side a little bit. I mean, it's definitely not going to be plumb. Yeah, that's kind of what I was worried about when I was watching that auger go down there. It wanted to walk this way.
Well, you know, using the auger to put in posts is pretty imprecise.
Yeah,
you know?
Well, that's usually why they have the auger bigger, you know, yeah. Quite a bit bigger than the post. And you have that allowance to move it around in there.
Okay, so yeah, we're going to trim this side of the hole down a little bit so we can get it this way.
Yep.
Not much.
These are the prices you pay when you buy a piece of property that's a hill.
Right.
Oh, no. to push that bottom one out or bring the top one.
Yeah.
Suck it in. Don't piss off mom.
Yeah.
That is getting smarter. Right?
Yeah. Sure is.
Right, Bo? Yeah, what you said. Alright, well, at least I didn't have to walk down the hill. I got to take the skid.
No.
Sit down. All right, well, the rain seems to have showed up. It's not raining per se at the moment, but it's about to. I can feel it about ready to dump on us. So before we get all soaked, then we might be able to hurry up a little bit, not tending to the camera. So we're gonna end this, I guess, episode right here. And I'll get back to you later. Maybe sometime tomorrow, might be able to come out here with the skid steer, do a little bit of shuffling around with some gravel down here after this rainstorm gets out of here. Cause usually the driveway needs a little bit of attention after we get some rain coming down the hill. So thanks again for watching, and hopefully you guys, you know, like some of the content you're seeing here over at DIY Life, Mount Tammany Ridge. And yeah, just like, comment, subscribe if you wish, and that'd be great. Thanks again. Have a good day.